Hi everyone, Miss Elizabeth here with Making Music Matters. In this video today, we're going to be talking about the bowing variations for Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. So a variation is when something changes slightly, but some of the same material is still there. So in this case, we've already learned the melody of Twinkle, meaning our left hand is going to keep doing the same thing. Our variation is going to come with the bow, where we can change the rhythm for each note, so that it sounds a little bit different. In our first rhythm, we can call it watermelon apple, Mississippi hot dog, or 16th notes and quarter, or eighth notes, excuse me. So 16th notes have the double line above. And so all four of these notes fit inside of one beat. The notes that have the one line above are our eighth notes. And both of these fit inside one beat. So for this variation, we're going to be doing Mississippi hot dog or watermelon apple, whichever way you like to think about it. You can even come up with your own words to remember your rhythms. But 16th notes and quarter notes. Let's hear what that sounds like with the first line of Twinkle. So we'll still start on open A and rock to the E. Like I said, our left hand is going to be doing the same thing. Now it's just our bow that will be doing the variation. So we start on A. 1, 2, 3. Should absolutely continue doing that bowing variation for the rest of the song. But I also want to talk about three other rhythms that we can try that we'll test out on the first line together in this video. The next rhythm are two groups of 16th notes together, or watermelon, watermelon, or Mississippi is a river. Or, like I said, you can come up with your own names. So just remember that the 16th notes have two bars on top. And all four of those notes fit inside one beat. So watermelon, watermelon. So the bigger beat is what is keeping us grounded and at a steady tempo. So let's try that first line with watermelon, watermelon. 1, 2, 3. So that's what the first line sounds like with watermelon, watermelon. Our next rhythm, I like to call run, pony, run, pony. So these notes are actually one eighth note and two 16th notes together. So this fits inside one beat. So one run, pony fits inside the beat. So run, pony, run, pony, run, pony, run, pony. So let's try that first line with run, pony now. 1, 2, 3. Again, that's just the first line, but you should practice the whole song with Twinkle with each of these rhythms. The last rhythm that I would like to explore with you today is our triplet rhythm, or strawberry, strawberry. Actually, there's a lot of different fruits that are three syllables that help us remember the triplet rhythm. There's strawberry, pineapple, blueberry. You can choose your own, and I sort of like to think of it as making a little smoothie. So the triplet is three notes together, and again, all three of those fit inside of one beat. But the difference between a triplet and the 8th and 16th notes is that these are all even. The 8th and 16th notes, the 16th notes are more played more quickly. And the triplet, all of them are even. So strawberry, 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 rather than run, pony, run, pony, run, pony, run, pony. So for the strawberry, strawberry, or whichever fruit you pick, just make sure that your bow is nice and even and singing and smooth. So let's play the first line with our triplet rhythm now. So again, that's the first line of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star with all four of these bowing variations. But you should play the whole song with one bowing variation before moving to the next. So right now, I'll go back to the Mississippi Hot Dog or Watermelon Apple and play through the whole song with that bowing variation. One, two, three. So that's what it sounds like all the way through with the first bowing variation. Now remember, our left hand is doing the exact same thing. So if you still need more practice plopping all three fingers down after we play open E, you can even practice that with these bowing variations too to make sure that both arms are coordinated. And remember that our elevator elbow still is rocking. So, I'm going to play the open E to D, or three on the A, with this Watermelon Apple or Mississippi Hot Dog rhythm to make sure that I'm plopping all three of my fingers and that my elevator elbow is rocking up for the A string. So I'm just going to rock back and forth about three times. One, two, three. And you can try that to build that coordination and muscle memory with each of the rhythms that we just discussed. Happy practicing!